Hi, and welcome to CardiyoFit. I'm Susan Reardon, and this is my colleague Emily, and we are going to take you through a fantastic fusion workout today, consisting of yoga, Pilates, Tabata, and some strength and conditioning. With that being said, we're going to start with a nice, easy, gentle yoga flow to get the juices flowing, and then we'll take it from there. Ready, okay. Emily?
Yes.
All right, so we're going to stand to the front of our mat, shoulders relaxed. Spread your toes, plant your feet into the mat, pushing down through the heels. We're going to take a big inhale up. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale to flat back. Exhale, fold. We're going to plant the hands and step back into our high plank. We're going to inhale here. On the exhale, lower down to chaturanga. Inhale to up dog. Exhale, curl the toes under. Downward facing dog. We're going to stay here for three breaths. Big inhale and exhale. Maybe with each exhale, we're spreading our fingers, pressing our heels down into the mat. One more big exhale here. Good. And we're gonna walk our feet to the front of the mat. We're gonna inhale to flat back, exhale to fold, and inhale all the way up. Arms come up overhead. And exhale to heart center. Good, let's go through that again, Emily. Big inhale up. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale to flat back. Exhale, fold. Plant the hands, step back to high plank. Inhale, exhale, lower to chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Curl the toes under, exhale, downward facing dog. Staying here for three breaths. Here's one. And just relax, the head is heavy. Two, inhale, and exhale. And one more deep breath here, and exhale. Walk to the front of your mat. Stand and fold, inhale to flat back. Exhale, back down to fold, and inhale it all the way up, slowly rolling up one vertebrae at a time. Arms reach up high overhead, and exhale, hands to heart center. Two more times. Palms at your side, and inhale, arms up. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale to flat back. Exhale to fold, plant the hands, step back. Inhale, exhale, down to chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Curl the toes under, and exhale, sit back, downward facing dog. Third dog of the day, Emily, let's just walk our dog a little bit, plant our feet down, walking the heels back and forth. Let's stay here for two more breaths, holding steady. Here's two, and exhale, one more, and exhale. Good, let's hop our feet forward this time. Slowly rolling it up, inhale to flat back, exhale to fold. Inhale all the way up. Big deep breath, filling our lungs, and bring our hands to heart center. Exhale, one more time. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale to flat back. Exhale to fold, plant the hands, step back into our high plank. Inhale here. Exhale down, slowly down to chaturanga. Inhale to up dog. Exhale. Curl the toes under, downward facing dog. Let's stay here for three breaths. And exhale. And inhale. And one more time, big deep breath in, filling those lungs up. Big exhale here. Looking between our thumbs and jumping forward to the front of our mat. Inhale up to flat back. Exhale to fold. Inhale all the way up, filling up our lungs. Arms reach up high overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. All right. We're going to start off with some pretty intense Tabata for our next circuit, Emily. So let's just take a second to stretch out our legs. So we're going to start with a quad stretch here, grabbing onto right leg if you need a wall or a couch or a chair. Sometimes just finding your drizzy or your focal point will help you balance. And let's change to the other side, making sure our supporting knee is softened in an unlocked position. Good, hold here, five more seconds. Two, and release. Okay, we're gonna start off with a Tabata series today, but we're gonna change it up a little bit. Typically it's one exercise, 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest, for a total of 8 times. Today, we have a combination of squats and push-ups. So we're gonna do those 8 times each, but we're gonna alternate back and forth.
Okay.
So really gonna get our heart rate up right out of the gates.
Don't doubt it.
All right, feet shoulder width apart. And then we're gonna keep the abdominals engaged. We want to make sure our knees track right over our ankles, sitting back into our heels. You can put the hands up at your heart center, on your waist, whatever works for you. All right, Emily, are we ready?
Ready.
All right, 20 seconds, basic squat, and 3, 2, and begin. Press down, squeeze up. So when you come up, really contract those glutes. Press down through your heels, come up, squeeze your glutes. Good. As many reps as we can get in. Don't forget to breathe, that's important. Last 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, let's go right down for our push-ups. And we have so many reps to do today, we're gonna do them on our knees. If you're feeling super strong and you wanna challenge yourself, feel free to do them on your toes at home. I think Emily and I are gonna opt for our knees. All right, 20 seconds, and here we go. Chest down and up, get them nice and deep. Wrist creases to the front of your mat. Tummy's in. Now you can have your feet up, cross the ankles, or down on the floor. Excellent, we have last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice, 10 second breather while we come back up to standing position. Squats round 2, feet shoulder width apart. And 3, 2, and here we go. Good. Remember guys, press down through the heels, shoulders relaxed. Come up really contracting those glutes. Get everything you can out of every move that you do. We're here, we're starting to get sweaty, and you signed up to work out, so let's make the most of it. Good, last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now there's a catch here with the 10 second break because we're transitioning for our
exactly.
Next exercise.
I was waiting for the break.
We're here, we're breaking. That being said, push-ups, round 2, let's do it. 20 seconds. Now when doing a push-up, guys, notice how Emily has her shoulder right over her elbow, which is directly over her wrist. When you have your hands out too far, it makes it too challenging and it puts undue stress on the neck. Last 3, 2, and 1. Nice, Emily, come on up.
Thank you.
10 second breather, squats round 3.
Get set, you mean.
And 3, 2, here we go. Press down, up, and squeeze those glutes all the way back up to standing. Squeeze. 20 seconds of beautiful before you know it. Don't forget to breathe. Oxygen is your friend. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Transition down. Push-ups. Remember, feet up, cross at the ankles, or feet flat on the floor. In 3, 2, and begin. Round 3, push-ups.
Feels more challenging if your feet are on the floor.
And that's the idea, Emily. I think she's on to me.
I am.
Good, 10 seconds. You might start to feel some heat between those shoulder blades. Just a little lactic acid, breathe through it. Last 3, 2, and 1. Back up on our feet. We're getting there. Round 4 of squats. Big deep breath in. Feet underneath the shoulders. And squat it up. Now, if you're getting a little tired at home, you can slow your pace down a little bit. The idea is to just do as many as you can in that 20 second window. Last 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Back down. Simple yet effective.
Yes.
Push-ups, here we go. 20 seconds. Now, push-ups can become really challenging, especially for us girls, because we just don't have the upper body strength that the boys do. There is another way we can modify our push-ups, and that's just by being on hands and knees, doing them here. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So, Emily, we can modify in the next circuit if we're starting to feel a little fatigued. Yeah. Halfway through, guys. Squats, round 5. Here we go. Down and up. Get that booty way back. You should be pressing down through those heels. 10 seconds. And And 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it down. Okay, I'm gonna say the other way to do the push-ups is just on hands and knees without the hips lower down. So if that feels better, you can try them like that. All right, here we go. Down and up, push-ups. So again, guys, I'm just gonna show you the modified version. Three ways to do a push-ups. Hands and knees, hips low, or on the toes. Good, last 5, 4, 3. Emily's getting a workout. 2, and 1. Nice, bring it on up, Emily.
Definitely am.
All right, feet underneath the shoulders. 3, 2, round 6. Shoulders relaxed, abdominals feeling strong. Squeezing those glutes, pressing down to those heels. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's bring it down. Push-ups, round 6. So remember your option. Hands and knees, down on the knees with the hips to the floor or on the toes. Here we go, Emily. Down and up. So inhale down, exhale on the push-up. 10 seconds from here. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Two more rounds to go. That's fatigue.
It is.
That's good stuff. That means we're making it happen. 20 seconds, squat it out. Down and up. So you might have a little bit of a, you might feel a little bit tight as you're going down into your squat, and that could be just an indicator of tight hip flexors. So just go with what feels good. As long as the form is good, you're pressing down to those heels, you're squeezing up with those glutes. 3, 2, and 1. You're making some good stuff happen.
Yes.
All right. Hands in position and begin your push-ups. 20 seconds. One more round after this, so stay with us. Tummy's in tight, even if you're slowing down your reps. Notice Emily's just changed to the hands and knees version. She's fighting the fire, but it might be getting the best of her. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Last round, bring it on up. 5 seconds. Last round of squats, here we go. Down and up. Every once in a while, just check down. Make sure those toes are still nice and straight. Feet are underneath the shoulders. Down and up. Maybe with each squat you're getting a little deeper, or each round you're getting a little bit deeper. Don't forget to contract those glutes on the way up. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Last round of push-ups. I think these are harder than the squats.
They are. My squats are my rest. Might be different for everyone.
All right, last round, Emily, let's do it. Down and up. Very nice. Keeping tummies in, guys. Don't let those hips sag. Don't compress that spine. Inhale down, exhale, push. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's take a second here and sit back into child's pose. Stretch out that low back. Sit the glutes down through your heels. Let's roll it back nice and slow. Just a quick little neck roll, right to left, and left to right, just in case we strain our neck, or because we're definitely working that to stabilize our head as we're doing our push-ups. Let's grab a drink of water, and then we're gonna move on to our next circuit. Okay, our next series is going to be some Pilates work. We're gonna basically do 10 of each exercise with the exception of a couple of stretches. So we're gonna start down on our mat, and we're gonna bring our legs up into tabletop. And the idea when doing these exercises is to keep our head, neck, and shoulders lifted off the mat. Knees are over the hips at a nice 90 degree bend. So already starting with shoulder blades elevated off the mat, elbows spread wide, thumbs behind our ears. We're just gonna crunch and down. Here's two, three, four, five, six. Really scoop that belly in. Seven, eight, nine. Last one, up and hold. We're gonna release our arms, put them by our side, and just alternate and pump. One, two, three, keeping those shoulder blades up high. Four, chin is slightly tucked down towards the chest. And seven, eight, nine, and 10. Holding here, we're gonna straighten out our legs and continue with the arm pumps. Here's one, two, three, four. Scoop that belly in. Navel down to our spine, imprint, down on the mat. Last three, two, and one. Let's just come down and take a little stretch. Hands out to the side, palms down, and we're just gonna drop our knees over to the left side and turn and look over to the right. Little spinal twist here. And let's drop our knees over to the other side, look over our opposite shoulder, head turn to the left, knees over to the right. Big inhale here. And exhale. Legs are out straight, and we're just gonna roll it up into a seated position. Sitting nice and tall on our mat, we're really gonna scoop our belly, and we're gonna take a big inhale, eyes up. We're gonna exhale and reach our fingertips over our toes. So nice long leg line, feet together. Let's inhale here. Exhale, bend it out, really pull in that belly button, push all of that air out, hold for three, two, pull it back, and inhale. And exhale, reach it out, and hold for four, three, scooping that belly in, two, and one. Good, nice and tall, shoulders relaxed down away from the ears. Big inhale here. And exhale, reach it out over those toes for four, three, getting rid of all of that breath, and one, pull it back. Inhale here. Exhale and reach over those toes. Maybe each time we're getting a little bit longer, a little bit deeper, a little bit more flexible, and pull it back. We have one more. Big inhale. And exhale, reach it out for four, three, two, and one. We're gonna move on now to saw. So we're gonna put our feet to the corners of our mat. Arms are out laterally. We twist through our core and reach for two. Ready, Emily?
Ready.
Here we go, and twist. One, two, and inhale. Exhale, two, inhale. Good, here's four, and center. Go to the outside of that pinky toe if you can. Here's six, and center. Seven, and center. Good, eight, bring it up. Nine, one more, and 10. Excellent. We're gonna roll it down on our mat. We're gonna go into a shoulder bridge with a march. So we're gonna lie it down. Get nice and comfy. We're gonna lift our glutes off of the mat. Feet are hip distance apart. Lace our fingers behind our mat, pressing those shoulder blades down, lifting those hips up to the ceiling. Tummy is tight to protect that low back. We're gonna start by driving our right knee in and lower. Here's left and lower, right. Keeping those hips up, don't let them drop. Pulling that navel in, five more, five. Four, three, two, and one. Excellent, lower down. We're gonna go into classic Pilates series five. So we're gonna lift head, neck, and shoulders off the mat. We're gonna grab onto our left knee. Inhale for two, exhale, switch legs, really peeling those shoulder blades up. Here we go. Here's, and two. And three, you can hear Emily with the breath. Five, good, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Excellent, bring those knees in, keep those shoulder blades lifted. Arms come above the head, nice long leg. And inhale, bring it in. And exhale, reach it out. And inhale, bring it in. And exhale, reach, inhale, Exhale, reach. There's three. And there's four. Big reach. And five. Don't forget, guys, imprint that spine on your mat. Pull that belly button in. We're really working on that core. If you're starting to feel like your low back is lifting off the mat, just bring those legs up a little higher. Good. Last three. Big reach. Here's three. Pull it in. Two. Pull it in. Last one. Pull it in. And let's come down just for a moment. Rest our neck. Bring those feet down, and we're now going to go into crisscross. So, thumbs behind the ears, fan the elbows out wide. Again, lifting head, neck, and shoulders off the mat. Emily, we're going to start with the right elbow to the left knee. Again, make sure that your legs are at a point where you can maintain your low back on the floor. If not, bring them up a little higher. Here we go for 10. Here's 10. And 9. 8. 7. 6. Nice flat back. 5. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, we're gonna hold here, legs up high. Make sure that that head is nice and comfortable. Press back into your fingertips, elbows wide, and scissor. 1, 2, 3, point those toes. 4, long legs. 5, 6, 7, oh yeah. 8, 9, and 10. Good. Hug those knees in. All right. Now we have a single leg stretch with a nice straight leg. So we're going to go nice and long, Emily. Shoulder blades are lifted. The same with the double breathing. Two inhales, two exhales. Here we go. Here's 4. 5. That's 7. 8, 9, and 10, and switch. Good. Hug those knees in. We're going to cross the ankles, palms out to the side. Let's drop our knees over to the left-hand side, look over to the right. And the cross of the ankles just creates a little bit of weight, a little bit deeper of a twist. And bring it back to center. Doesn't it feel wonderful after all of that? And change to the other side. Stretching is such a good reward for exercise. And bring it back into the center. Hug your knees into your chest. And let's roll it up to seated position. Okay. That's right. All right, let's go back into some cardio. So our next circuit is going to be four exercises. 1 minute each, and we're going to go through the circuit 2 times.
Okay.
So it's time to get sweaty again, if you're not sweaty already.
So we're going to all are.
I think we're pretty sweaty. All right, we're going to start with a lateral shuffle. So we're going to go as low as we can, weight down into our heels, hands clasped in front. We're just going to hop to the side with a tap. All right, so I'm going to give Emily some room here. 1 minute, shoulders down, stay low. Try to resist the urge to come back into standing tall position. Hands at your heart, 1 minute. Ready? And begin. So just down. Now, if the hop isn't doing it for you, you have low impact version is here. Maybe get a little bit lower if you're not incorporating that hop. We really want to fire off those quads. Work those glutes. This is a great exercise for the glute minimus and medius. Remember, our glutes are our strongest muscle in our body, and they control so much of what we do. So we need to keep them strong and looking good. All right, 30 seconds. Stay low. Nice and big.
After those quads.
Huh?
After those squats earlier. My quads are hurting.
Lots of fire going on today.
Yes.
15 seconds. Stay low. You can do it. Breathe it out. Doing great. 10. Last 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Hands on the hips. Weight in 2. Alternating reverse lunge. Big breath. Hands on your hips. 1 minute, let's start on the right leg. Here we go. So I want you to get nice and low. Knee close to the ground, but don't tap it. Don't forget to breathe. It helps a lot when you're working out. And bring it down. So shoulders back, nice and tall. Keep it going, Em. Crown of your head to the ceiling like there's a piece of string tied from the ceiling to your head, keeping those shoulders back. And nice, clean posture. And let me jump back with Emily here. We have 30 seconds.
Definitely takes balance.
Oh, yeah. Plus, we're already a little fatigued from all that other fun stuff that we've done.
Yes.
Fun. 10 seconds. Stay strong. 5, 4, 3, 2, ooh, and 1. I got a little too low. All right, next exercise is plank.
Okay.
Forearms. We have a 1 minute hold heel now. If you start to feel like you're losing form, hips are falling down, drop one knee, drop two knees. Ready?
Ready.
And bring it up, hold. 30 seconds. So I'm just gonna show you a couple of the modified versions of planks. Just aren't your thing or you don't feel like you've worked up to that quite yet. You can do them on your knees or with one knee lifted. You really wanna keep the shoulders over the elbow. The plank here is much less challenging than a plank way back here. 30 seconds, how are we doing, Emily?
We're burning.
You're gonna keep those hips up. Tailbone pointed slightly up. Good. Coming in. Here we go, we have 15 seconds. You got this.
It's nothing.
Piece of cake, right guys? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's just take a little stretch back into child's pose. 2 big breaths here. And one more. And the last one in the circuit, cross body mountain climbers. So plant the hands into high plank position. You have the option of doing a low impact or a high impact. Emily, which would you like to do today?
I'll do the low impact.
Yeah, of course you will, right? All right. So again, guys, remember to keep those wrists underneath your shoulders. 1 minute, keep those elbows soft. Eyes of your elbows facing in so you don't lock the elbows, and begin. 1, 2. And again, follow Emily with the low impact version. These also can be done on forearms, but I find these to be a little bit harder, being lower to the ground. Good, 1, 2, 1, 2. Crossing the body, opposite knee to elbow. 30 seconds. A long minute, huh?
It is.
High impact. Hop it out, Emily. Hop it out, girl. Keep those elbows soft. Nice. Last 10. Glutes down. Trying to lift the booty up too high. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Whew.
That's right.
That's a very long minute.
Let's grab a drink of water and we're gonna do it again. We're gonna keep you moving today. So right back up.
I guess so.
We're gonna go into that lateral shuffle. So down nice and low, hop and tap. Low as we can. 1 minute and begin. We gotta make sure we don't collide here. Come on, Emily, you can get a little lower. I know she can.
I was trying to time it so we're at opposite parts.
Don't worry, plenty of room. Stay low, tummy tight, shoulders back, booty down. 30 seconds. Are you breathing over there?
Sometimes I do forget.
Sometimes we don't forget. 15 seconds. 10. 5. Stay low. Stay low. 3, 2, and 1. Hands on the hips. Alternating reverse lunge this time. Let's start on the left. Okay. Big breath. One more. Let's do it. Left side. So remember, shoulders back, abs tight, nice and tall. Beautiful. 30 seconds. Oh, actually, 45. What was I thinking?
Psyching
I got excited.
Out.
Now we have 30 seconds. Ooh, I'm a little fatigued. I'm off balance. You might notice that you're getting a little bit wobblier. That's fatigue setting in.
This means you're working hard.
That's right. And that's what we're here to do. 15. Plank time. Woo. Come on down.
Right into it.
She loves this.
I do.
All right. Forearm plank. Big deep breath. Remember, guys, knees or toes or even one knee down. And begin. This is a very long minute. Use it as catch your breath time. Close your eyes, go to your happy place. At least we're not jumping or squatting or using those legs.
Sure.
Yeah. The bright side. 30 seconds.
One part of the body is getting a break. The other, not so much.
Bringing that heart rate down, settling into our plank. We have 15 more seconds from here. 10. Get the shake shut.
I do.
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's take a second. Stretch out that low back. One big breath. Now this time you have to do the high impact.
Okay.
She's such a good sport. All right. Crossbody mountain climbers.
Water.
She's hydrating, and make sure you do the same. Hydrate as you need to. Don't wait for us for those water breaks. All right, high plank position. Here we go. Cross body. Opposite knee to elbow, and making sure the eyes of your elbows are turned to the front so you're not locking. Nice, Emily. Those look great. One knee. Two. And don't think that the low impact are easy, because they're not. There's just, low impact just essentially means having one foot on the floor at all times. High impact, having both off. That's really what that translates to. We're getting there. 20 seconds. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's bring it down. And let's grab some water. We're going to go into our next series. Okay, we're going to start bringing it down a little bit. We're going to go through a power yoga series, a little bit of a modified sun salutation B, and then we'll end with a nice stretch and cool down. So we're going to start at the front of our mat. Doesn't it sound amazing? Mountain pose. Palms up. And we're going to inhale up to chair pose. So feet should be hip distance apart, toes straight. Make sure you can wiggle your toes, tummy in, shoulder back. Let's take a big inhale here and exhale to fold. We're gonna plant the hands. You can step or hop back. Lower down slowly, chaturanga. Inhale to up dog. Exhale to downward facing dog. Let's stay here for 2 breaths because we're gonna keep moving. And exhale, one more time, inhale. And exhale, looking between our hands, we're gonna step forward with our right foot. Take a big hit, inhale here, exhale up, warrior one. So putting the weight to the front knee, nice bent knee, strong as though we're trying to rip our mat in two. And we exhale to warrior two. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, warrior one. And exhale, warrior two. Let's stay here. We're gonna reverse our warrior, flip the palm up and reach, inhale. And exhale, bring it back. Let's do two more. Inhale, reverse your warrior. And exhale, bring it forward. One more, flip the palm, inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, windmill it down. Frame that front foot. Step back with that right leg. If you can, keep that right leg lifted, lower down to chaturanga. Inhale up to up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Stay here for two breaths. Exhale, one more. Exhale, walk or jump to the front of your mat. Stay here and fold. Inhale to flat back. Exhale to fold. Inhale all the way up. Hands up overhead, exhale, hands at heart center. Let's start down in Tadasana again, mountain pose. Inhale it up to chair pose. And press down through those heels, feet are hip distance apart, make sure you can wiggle your toes. Exhale to fold. Inhale to flat back. Exhale to fold, plant the hands. Walk or jump back to high plank. Inhale here, exhale down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. We're gonna stay here for two breaths. One more. Gaze between your hands, step forward, right leg. Inhale, up, warrior one. Again, bending through that front knee. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, warrior two. One more. Inhale, warrior one. Ooh, I almost lost my balance. Exhale, warrior two. Let's hold it here. One deep breath in. Flip that palm up. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, bring it back to warrior two. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, warrior two. Last one, inhale. Reverse your warrior. Exhale, warrior two. Windmill those hands down. Plant down, step back to high plank. Leave that left leg up, lower down slowly into chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Curl your toes under. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's stay here for two breaths. And one more. And walk or jump to the front of your mat. Inhale to flat back, exhale to fold. Inhale it all the way up. Arms reaching up high. Exhale, hands to heart center. Nice way to cool it down. We're gonna bring it down on the mat. So have a seat, feet together. And we're just going to do very gentle little ab exercise just to cool it down. And why not hit those abs one more time? So feet together, Emily, knees out wide, lifting head, neck, and shoulders off the mat and pulse. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and five, four, three, two, and one, hold it here, pull that belly button in for five, four, three, two, and one. Good, let's roll it down. Plant the hands down next to your sides, palms facing down, extend the legs long. And let's inhale here, exhale, roll it up into a seated position, nice long legs. Let's walk our hands out towards our feet, shoulders down. Rolling down chin to chest. Let's take a big inhale here and exhale, flatten it out. Good. And let's spin it around. Let's go just down onto our bellies into a small cobra. Stretch out that low back. So we're gonna have feet flat on the floor, toenails down, elbows and shoulders down, away from your ears, hands at your side, inhale. Lift it up, curl your toes under. Exhale to downward facing dog. And let's just use our down dog as a nice deep hamstring stretch. So I really want you to get comfortable here. Plant those feet down. Push down to those heels, spread those fingers apart. And then we're gonna walk our feet slowly back towards our toes. And hold here. We're gonna grab opposite elbow. Hang here in ragdoll. Two big deep breaths here. And exhale. And one more, inhale. And exhale, let's take our right elbow and put it to the outside of our right knee, twisting through that waist, stretching out those lats, stretching out all through that low back, and then left elbow to left knee, twist and hold. And we're gonna release those hands, place them down on the mat, inhale to flat back, exhale to fold. Roll it up nice and slow, one vertebrae at a time, maybe skimming the front of your quads with your fingertips, hands up. And exhale, hands to heart center. Let's grab that right leg, quad stretch here. We did a lot of lower body today, so we need to stretch it out good. Make sure your supporting knee is nice and soft. Don't lock at the knee joint, so make sure you have some bend in that left knee. I want you to release that right leg, step it forward. Heels lifted on the back leg, sink down into split squat. Make sure your right knee is over your right ankle. Inhale the arms up, crescent pose, drop those shoulders down, turn those pinkies in, push that back hip forward, and breathe. One more deep breath. Excellent, we're gonna drop that back knee down. We're gonna plant the hands and sink back, pulling our toes up on that right foot, and get a nice hamstring stretch here.
Feels good.
Split squat, yes, it does feel good. Okay, let's walk it back. Plant the hands, framing the front foot, lifting your knee off the mat, back leg, take the right arm, spin it up, reach it high. Good, bring that hand down the inside, and then slowly walk it up that bent knee. Good, step it in. And let's go back, other leg. Step it back, making sure knee's right over that front ankle. Bend that back knee, split squat position, push that hip forward, inhale, arms up. Turn those pinkies in, drop those shoulders, crescent pose. Let's stay here for two breaths. Exhale. One more. And exhale, good. Come down, plant the hands, straddle that left foot, spin the left arm up, and hold it here. Good, bring those hands down on the inside. Drop that knee down and sink back. Pop those toes up on the left and stretch out that hamstring. Flex those toes back towards your face, get nice and deep. Maybe get a little calf in there. Good, come forward, plant the hands down, lift that back knee up, walk it up that left leg and step it in. Lace your fingers behind your back, squeeze your shoulder blades together, knees are soft, chest up, hold it here. Good, let's stack our hands, one on top of the other, shoulders down. Open up your feet, a little wider than shoulder width. Press those palms out, shoulders down, chin to chest, roll it forward. And big reach forward, keeping those knees soft, round out that back. Good, and release those arms down, bring it up, right ear to right shoulder. Fingertips right above your temple, left fingertips reaching down for the floor. And bring that chin down to chest. Keeping the chin on the chest, switch hands, pull slightly over to the left. Left ear to left shoulder. Let's take that head back up to center, big deep breath in. And exhale. One more time, big deep breath in, and exhale. We hope you enjoyed your workout. Thank you so much for checking out CardiyoFit, and we will see you next week.
Bye.